I know this theme.
I know this song. Hey, welcome to the radio program, everybody. This is Full Spectrum Cycling, show number 281, if I'm not mistaken.
I think you are correct.
That's what it says on the cheat sheet here. So
mine was loading improperly, so I believe it is all correct.
I believe
now.
In you, JK. Mm-hmm. That's JK over there with the Public Image Limited shirt on. And playing the part of Tony tonight is D’Nardo.
I'm not Tony.
But I did work with him.
Right. I want to be him.
Tony's, I guess, feeling under the weather. I'm Sven, of course. And this, again, is Full Spectrum Cycling. And we'll see you next week. Bye.
See you later.
Right on. Crush into the variety pack time.
I don't even know what happened last week. I kind of lost track of almost the whole week somehow.
Oh, right.
I planned to do my, some miles towards my 100.
Mm-hmm.
No. Shoulders hurting. Like,
Yeah. But that's always...
It's getting better. Next week, when it's cold out, I'll have to put in some extra miles and warm up.
Sure. Jumped on Steed, went down to the WMSE front of studio just to hop on the hop because the Boogie Bang was doing their live remote.
On the hop?
Yeah.
No way.
So
was that last Wednesday?
Saturday.
Oh, Saturday. Okay, because I know I heard him talking about it. I thought it was... Are they doing it more often now?
They're trying to. I mean, it was a good time.
It's a good bit. They just roll around on the hop and...
Yeah, Chris Treeter did one a few months ago, and this was the second one. And
so, Boogie Bang, what happened to Craig McNeil? Like, he used to be there with...
Barry.
Yeah,
I've
seen him. I saw him at RW24, but like he just disappeared.
Sometimes they just eject.
I guess
and
so.
Return. I mean, it's all volunteer. I mean, apart from the...
It's the greatest radio station in the world.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know, because Tony's not here, so we don't have any actual on-air WMSE.
Maybe I got something in my bag.
Well, the artwork is from WMSC. Art is from MSC.
Adjacent.
For their February art thing. I usually buy a piece or two.
Nice.
We'll see how that goes this year.
I need some more
Newski stuff. I like the Newski stuff.
He's pretty great.
Didn't he just put a book out?
Yeah, he did.
Yeah,
he did.
Okay.
And he's been playing around too with the band or with the hymn.
Yep.
We biked around Lake Michigan, Alicia and I, and we were in Charlevoix, something. I think that's the name of the town.
Sure, on the other side of the pond.
On the other side of the pond. And it was like we went out, and there was Newski playing. We're like, Newski, yeah! It was awesome.
It's one of those right-on things.
Yeah, it was great.
Yeah.
Yeah, my first, I believe you were there as well. First introduction to Newski was at a Lebowski Fest. Playing the atrium of the
Pabst Theater.
Yep. Like just an afternoon lunch concert or whatever the day of them playing Lebowski in Cathedral Square.
Full on white Russian action.
Oh, God, I miss Lebowski Fest. Come on back. that was so grand.
It hasn't been here for a while, but it should come back.
Yeah.
I think I mentioned my buddy Wick before. He's a Wickster on Facebook. He's a bike industry guy. He used to be part of Core. I don't know exactly what he's doing now, but he's been around forever. But if he doesn't look like the dude, nobody else looks like the dude. And when we did trade shows, when those were a big thing back before the big 2020 pandemic thing, their booth always had like a 20-foot bar behind the curtain.
Oh, brilliant.
Yeah. Good stuff. He had gotten his truck stolen and his trailer, and he does cyclocross events, other cycling events on the West Coast, mostly Oregon, Washington and such over there. But I guess he got it back. So I don't know if all the gears in it haven't hurt yet, but, that's kind of the Lebowski tie in there.
Yes.
Hey, you know what's coming up? Hey, really soon is the winter bike party over at Amorphic.
Mm-hmm.
which will be December 4th, Wednesday night, if you're in Milwaukee
Wednesday,
that day.
Wednesday?
Be a good day to pop in. There's going to be some people that ride all year rounds telling you stuff about how they make that work for them. And since we haven't had snow for a few years, I guess it's not really that hard for anybody anymore.
Right,
but,
right. It's more, it's more of a cold prevention.
It's like, sideways rain. Yeah. That's the only thing that stops me.
What about ice? Don't.
Yeah.
No, studded tires. I got off my studded tire bike and fell to the ground.
Yeah, it gives you more confidence and a bit more stick.
If you're on a fat bike with studded tires, I think it's a lot like riding on gravel. You've got pretty decent traction.
Yeah.
Until
stuff goes kind of.
That's what I mean. But you mentally, you know, I mean, you have the confidence.
Right.
You know, but just don't take too much of the confidence.
Yeah. I've
biffed on ice way too many times that I don't.
Yeah, I had. Was mine.
I respect that damn ice.
Was mine last year or the year before when I did the skid into the ice, like directly into the ice?
Yes.
So we used to be across from Amorphic in that big building, right? Like 150, 200 feet away. So
yeah,
I'm like, well, I'm going to roll over there on the bike with the slicks on and the snow and the whatever. And, I'm just going to make a nice skid in the snow. Well, unfortunately, it wasn't gravel and snow. It was snow and ice. Oh, yeah. Boy. Oh, did that hurt. Yeah, you get up and you're like, oh, yeah.
I'm fine. Isn't that amazing how the body says, I'm fine, fine. And it's only like an hour later we realize, I think I broke something.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know if I broke anything that day, but...
Yeah, that's when I did the...
My pride, for sure.
Yeah, when I slipped, fell, tore bicep, and jammed thumb, but didn't really know that at the time. So the next morning
there
was...
There might have been other
numbing agents.
Circumstances.
Numbing agents that kind of dulled the reaction time. But not that bad. I was just walking. That was the thing. But then I got up in the morning to meet these guys to go down to the polar bear and watch the dips go in the dip. And it was progressively like, I can't really use my left arm at all. But I'm biking still. I'm just like, okay, well, we're just going to do this one-handed, aren't we? And then it was just like, I think it's a very good idea if I go home. Everyone wanted to go to the swinging door.
Oh, yeah, that's funny.
I'm like, I don't think
wait,
did
you say it's a good idea I should go home and then you went to the swinging door?
No.
That's what I heard. I just
no, they were going to
the
swinging door, but I was like, okay. I'm like, oh, the call of the door was dissuaded that much. I was like, oh, no. It's just a poor idea.
I tried to do that without hearing anything. I think I didn't call into the call-in studio call screener line.
Oh, oopsie.
Oh, well. What's going on here?
Is something bad?
No, it just means that I didn't set it up for a call-in guest today. Hey, Mark, if you're calling in, we'll get at you next week. Or I could do it now and...
We'll just talk.
You guys talk amongst yourselves.
We were.
I'll talk about my winter bike. I have the asymptotic bike. I have a Raleigh Tourist with rod brakes, right? So that they pull up and hit the rim from the underside.
Oh.
You have to have special rims for that. And I've got studded Schwabli tires on there.
Mm.
And the bike cannot be disassembled because everything is rusted shut, except for the drive mechanics, right? But when you pull the rod brakes, you slow down quickly, but you never actually stop. So you have to put your foot down
little Freddie Flintstone on it?
But when you... take off, it's really slow too, so everything is smooth and groovy, and that's what you want on snow and ice.
Mm-hmm.
You want smooth and groovy, and this bike is unstoppable.
Really?
Is it a good bike? No, but it's unstoppable. I love that bike.
Good for this.
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah, that's like my purple beater. It's just perfect for
what you need it for.
Yeah. This bike, you know, I flatten here and I don't want to deal with it and this, that, the other. Okay.
So all these people have
boom.
They're like $5,000 bikes. And I'm like, this was $150 and I put like $50 worth of tires on. And
nice. Albeit the clunker is very in line to usurp my purple alt as the.
Oh, like the new
the winter bike of choice?
Just the yeah, default bike of
ready to roll.
Yeah. Just like speaking
of clunkers, mostly for Milwaukee folks, I'd imagine, but anybody's interested in that found piece of machinery in the other room, the Jameis. Ooh, excuse me. It's kind of burpy beer.
Yeah, they are known for
it. It is a Jameis Boss Cruiser, which is a coaster brake bike. It's Ruth Wiles, but said anybody is interested in it, she'd be willing to let it go for a very reasonable price. And it's a cool bike. It's got handlebars about yay wide. It's got a nice crate rack on the front of it, and it's coaster brake, which is awesome.
Yeah. It can be.
You know what I'd love?
If you can mentally get your
I'd love a coaster brake that if you backpedal gently, you could backpedal. And it's, holy shit! And then you actually activate the coaster brake. But I love to backpedal.
Yeah, right?
Just like strolling down the street, like moonwalking when you're riding.
Yeah. Backpedaling is a thing for me, right?
It would be like akin to like clipping. You know what I mean? Like clipping your, like clipless.
Yeah.
I think... mentally, I'm getting for the coaster, you'd have to like do a little shimmy with your foot.
Oh, right. I just meant holy shit. I meant like panic mode.
It's
and then
just
the brakes.
Some sort of G force or some kind of.
Well, like your seatbelt. It's like your seatbelt. You can lean forward. But then when something happens, it locks in place.
Right.
That's what I want for the coaster brake.
How does it know?
It's magic.
Yeah. No.
I think it's called physics.
That's magic.
Yeah.
Just with numbers.
Very, very
true.
I'm going
to stand up. I can't stand the squeaking.
Right on. That's your 1960s era kind of mod chair, you know? So.
Yeah, it does have the Orange Julius kind of.
I got new orange chairs in the other room, but, you know, those are new.
Yeah. Can't sit
well, I mostly got them because that table in there is a lot taller, and these don't go up and down. So you'd be like, the table would be like right here. That would be weird. That'd be like strange.
Speaking of Orange Julius, we saw Modest Mouse the other night. That was a pretty fun show. It was like the one voice, and that was it, right?
You know, he the only original guy left?
So it turns out everybody. They're touring, doing the good news for bad news people, whatever that, you know what I mean? It's like good news for people who like bad news. They're redoing that album. Everybody who made that album is alive, but only he was on tour.
Gotcha.
It's like, but you know, it's Modest Mouse voice. So, like, can you imagine the band without him? It's like, they'd be perfect, but wait a second. Hold on.
Oh yeah. Yeah. The dance. Yeah. Yeah. Where were they playing? Excuse me. Good Lord.
Riverside.
Messing around with stuff here.
Sorry to say, was the security just a pain in the ass? The TSA line, I mean?
No, not really.
You can.
I mean, first
you,
of all, you I'm, don't have, no, I'm no. old, and they like they just see the gray hair, and they're like, just get in. You know, I did this.
I did this.
Was right. I didn't drop prance or anything.
No, I had something in my pocket. And then it was like something went off. Beep, 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 beep. Okay, then you're good. I'm like, what? Did I just like Jedi mind trick this guy without even like thinking or knowing I did that?
That's like how I used to go on airplanes, right? I have it in my pocket because it was wood and it's like I clear everything.
Yeah.
And then go to the bathroom at 30,000 feet and just walk out just like, I think I'm the highest guy on this airplane. Like, I love that. I don't do that. No, I love Jesus.
Can't do that anymore.
Yeah,
you can't smoke anything on an airplane, not even your little
I bet I could get away with it. I totally bet I could get away with it. How hard is it to hold your hit till it's gone and then... into the little trash
like
can thing.
Super, yeah. Well, no, like the super.
Because it's got some good suction.
Yeah.
But you have to time it.
You got to time it. Don't cough. Yeah. Right? No coughing.
But that's the thing. You got to cough to get off. I mean, it's such a. What to do, world. See, these are the thoughts. These are the conspiracy theories I like. Not the creepy, painful, dangerous ones.
All righty. Good stuff.
Uh-oh.
Ian. Oh, let's do that. Are we at the top of the hill? We'll talk about Ian. We'll talk about Ian once we're on the top of the hill. Just because you're re-upping there.
Yeah.
JK brought a three Floyds variety pack today. Our first space whistle or speed castle or
speed
whatever.
Speed castle. World ending Pilsner.
For a Pilsner,
yeah,
it's
pretty good.
It's very tasty. It's
totally good.
I would do it.
Yeah.
I would do it. If I found that at a bar, I'd be like, yeah, sure.
I kind of miss Compai, as I call them. That was where Space Whistle was from.
Ah, there it space is. Whistle. That's why the name was damn familiar. Space Whistle.
The next, what's next on the Turbo Reaper is the next on the list here.
It's a normal.
Clearly, I'm not keeping up.
7% IPA. It's not normal. Without warning, something's dawning at our latest West Coast-style IPA awaits your defenseless thirst. As colossal hop aromas ride in harmony with tropical and citrus notes, you better run for cover.
Yeah.
There is no other.
They always have just great art, and most of the time, their beers really hit well.
Three Floyds is good.
Yeah. I mean, this is 7, but it doesn't taste like a 7. It's not like super heavy.
D’Nardo stood up.
It's all about you have to let it.
Yeah, get those digestive tracks over going.
Gotta go for a walk.
Yeah, go like this. Good. Twist.
Wait, I can't do that.
Range of motion now.
Literally,
Have you been using your elastics?
No, I have a pulley system. It's like a torture device. And you up and down. Like this?
I think I saw a picture of you. Didn't you have like the little weird machine?
That was, you put it in, it goes. There's a picture of me asleep.
Yeah. On the... So how far post-op are you?
5 weeks.
And you're out of the chair now?
God, no, that's long gone. I'm fine. I just, you know, I'm trying to be good. I don't want to hurt it again, right? So...
Yeah, so soon anyway.
When can I bike? You know.
So, yeah,
but that's all fine. But I went to physical therapy and they're like, "Can you do this?" And I'm like, "Yeah, I can do that. Can you do this? Yeah, I can do that." And they're like, "What's the matter with you?" And I'm like, "I don't know." Like,
well, the one that got me, and it even hurts on this, even though he claims that it's no tear or anything, it's just bruised or something, is when you're unloading the dishwasher. I don't know if you do that at your house.
Yeah.
But when you put that, you'd make that motion like this with the plates to put them up on the shelf. That's the one that kept being like, yeah, that's not ready yet to do that.
That's exactly the same thing. Like grab the milk out of the fridge and do this. That's not going to happen. Not a gallon of milk. Ooh. Yeah, yeah. It's not
going to happen. Our buddy Ian from Bicycle Benefits.
Hmm.
Local guy now, I guess, because he sent me a text today and said, what do you think about doing a Riverwest Social Ride next spring that would be like a weekly thing? Like, sounds like a good idea to me.
Right.
Some of the rides that kind of had been happening seem to have tapered a little bit. I'm not sure what the best night would be, you know, if there's still a Tuesday night ride or a Wheelie Wednesday or whatever, but I like the idea.
Yeah.
And he's kind of just looking for ideas, maybe brainstorm a little bit if there's something like, well, we could just go to bars around River West, I guess. You know, it's like there's plenty of them, but, you know.
But that's kind of what everybody does anyway.
So yeah. What else might kind of fit in and be fun? And at least one maybe non-alcoholic stop per ride, possibly. I don't know. That's my idea.
Right on. Yeah.
You could just go to the...
Like the Annie Pie rides.
Yeah, go to the bookstore. Go to the, you know, go to the jazz estate gallery thingy. Jazz, what's it called? Jazz Gallery.
Jazz Gallery of...
Yeah. Oh, you mean on... Center Street. Center, yep.
There's plenty of businesses in River West that are not...
The Falcon?
Not all... Oh, yeah, the Ball. That would be a good place to either start or end.
They do a Tuesday swing... swing dancing, swing...
Really?
Is that the same group of cats that used to be up at the old Shorewood Post, do you think?
No, it's all greasy. Yeah. Like Hustler and Larry Flinty. No, yeah, it's like swing dancing.
Oh, boy. You know what's coming up?
I thought about it as I said it. I was like, well, okay, yeah, we talked dancing. Yes.
We talked winter party. You know what's coming up right after that on the Saturday after the winter party is Global Fatbike Day / Santa Rampage already coming up here in a couple weeks.
I'll just ride my fat bike on Santa Day, maybe.
Yeah. There's a bunch of listings.
That's how I spot the difference.
If you go to the show notes, there's a bunch of listings of places around. There's a lot of them in Wisconsin that are doing Stevens Point and Eau Claire and, you know, Milwaukee and Madison. Lots of places doing their own version of the Santa Rampage, which I assume has some fat bike angle.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if I mentioned this before. I know I was thinking about it, but I don't know if the words came out of my mouth. Can you hear the words coming out of my mouth? So a guy picked up some wheels today, and his girlfriend or partner picked them up for him, and she works for the bike fed and is stationed down at the Wheel and Sprocket on Beecher Street with access to all that entails of people who run, own, and or work at that place. And there was some hubbub about Huge Ass being like it's been 10 years now for criminies. Is it with no snow? Is it still a thing? It's actually part of my notes here before I even talked to her about that. Was like, what about moving Global Fat Bike Day to North, like January or February when we may have a better chance of snow?
That's what make definitely makes
at
sense.
Least. In a good chunk of the United States, America. I don't know about overseas how they're dealing with these.
Huge Ass at this point just kind of seems like almost like cyclocross
or mountain bikes on fat bikes
and flagging hammer.
There is that element, of course. But yeah,
I know I'm getting the Swedish chef, but it's all the
I have a shrinking
and shrinking more percentage of my German heritage the more people are doing ancestry.com and whatever.
That Turbo Reaper.
It's all the French and the Luxembourgers, man.
It's the Luxembourgers. I am a Luxembourger, by the way.
Aren't you too, somewhere?
Yep.
No. Officially. Do you have a passport?
No. Okay. But, I mean, in the lineage.
I can move.
So does he have to whack you to get to the
He's going to have to
thorn,
like, do something.
The throne.
I think we're far enough apart that he's got to start all over again. Unless you got Burmish. Do you got Grandpa Burmish on your side?
Do I have Burmish?
We're related, by the way.
Does it show?
How many
Does
cousins
it sound
away?
Show? We're cousins.
Yeah. I mean, it's complicated.
We're not inbred.
His grandma and my grandma were cousins. And
my grandma,
and their brother, their husbands were cousins, so it was like a double cousin wedding, cousin. It's like
not inbreeding though, just far enough away.
People say your mom is your cousin, your sister.
Yeah,
everybody's your cousin.
Sweet.
It's Wisconsin. We're allowed to do this.
Exactly.
You know, I looked this up. I heard that we could marry our first cousin in Wisconsin. I was that's disgusting.
Until what year?
You still can.
Oh, okay.
Today, you can marry your first cousin as long as she is over 50. So
what?
You can't have babies with your first cousin.
Oh, okay.
But you can marry him. You can hold out for 50 years. You can hold out of pure love and then marry your first cousin.
Huh.
That's a weird.
When you can't have a baby. Isn't that weird?
A strangely thoughtful statue. Yeah.
That would be
full of thought, only
for the woman, right? Because the guy can probably have babies until he's 85.
Yeah, or maybe.
Like Tony Randall or somebody like that.
Tony Randall. Let's just go there.
85, right?
What?
That was a fine curveball. I was not expecting
good. Good on him. However, but like you have a kid, and now you there's no way he's there past 100.
Well, yeah, even if they're in, that would be the kid's only 15. What a way to bring a kid.
Yeah, no.
You think it was like an oops, or?
I can't speak.
He's such
that.
An acrobat. Such a sexual acrobat in the world.
I hate to say it, though. Like, given who he was, his TV persona, I love that. I love that. I was like, what? Are you kidding?
Fma. Fma. Yes, indeed. Okay, so here's something that I don't want to forget before we get out of this, which is coming. Next week is Thanksgiving. That's the noise gate, by the way.
Thanks, taken.
It goes. It just like it'll cut in. Anyway, next week's Thanksgiving, so I'm thinking we should. We'll do the show the same night, but I'll post the show on Wednesday, so people that are traveling can listen to the show.
Dulcet tone.
Or watch us on YouTube.
Brilliant.
Because everybody's going to be traveling, apparently, except for us. I'm not. Well, I'm traveling to Brookfield.
I'm going to West Bend.
Oh, you're going far afield.
Mm-hmm. I don't have to cook this year.
What's your Thanksgiving plan?
We're bringing family in from Appleton. Every year, Alicia does a themed Thanksgiving. So this year is show tunes, which I hate. But I 3D printed Emmy Awards and everybody, Tony Awards. Everybody gets a Tony Award.
That's like a participant award, right?
Yeah, right. Everybody gets one.
Are they life size?
Yeah, they're real. I looked it up. I made it the right thing. So, you know, we got to paint the top silver. But
I thought you were going to say they're all little Tony Burgers.
Do you 3D print parts for the business?
All the time.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. It saves us thousands of dollars. Like, not even close. It's total. The printer is $1,500. We saved $5,000 this year.
Right on.
It's not even close.
And how big a thing can it make?
Well, you know. I mean,
are they
10 by 10?
So do you have to do them in pieces and then glue them together?
So, yeah, we have like something that's like too big, we have to make in two parts. And I've learned how to, I used to make like fancy little clips that snap into each other. That sucks.
Make glue. Just put some glue in there.
No, I do like nut and bolt. And so I make an opening for a nut and bolt, and then you just squeeze it together and glue it. And
nice.
Now it's invincible.
A guy that's been on the show before, Mr. Andrew Zahn, he of the RW24 Planning Committee, is a 3D printing, he does it quite a bit, and he made some kind of RC plane with it. And I'm curious, I got to see if it actually flies, because in my opinion, I've been doing RC forever, it was heavy. Speaking of RC, look at those little trucks right there. Those are fun for blasting around.
That's a sexy little number.
It's a little crawler. You can do some crawling with those things.
Does it go up a wall?
It doesn't quite do a wall right now, unless you had a winch, maybe.
Mike, do you remember when I gave you a Jeep like this? Mighty Mo? It wasn't a mini Mighty Mo, but it was a Mighty Mo. And you'd go, vroom, 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 had a flywheel in it, and it would go 70 miles an hour down the road. Do you remember that? And then you lost it. I remember that. I'm still holding that against you. How old am I? 60?
And how
fuck, I'm holding it against
you. Is he 5 years younger than you were?
Yeah. I'm still
years.
Mad.
Yeah.
How many years is that? That's like 50 years of rage.
Just built up. For this
I told
moment.
Your mom. For I just told moment. Your mom at your wedding. I told your mom. I'm still mad at him.
By the way, if you haven't watched JK's nuptials on the porch at the old Morris Mansion, that's... What show was that? 279 or something? It's in.
Yeah.
You can see the picture. Go check out.
That was
JK.
Great.
It was the best wedding I've ever been to, I think.
It was simple and beautiful.
And
no, it was awesome.
Came from a place of love, baby.
Aw.
Yeah.
Aww.
So the place where Wendy and I got married isn't even there anymore. It was like, it was Boaters on the River, which used to be a really cool place.
Yeah.
But
we
did everything there. We didn't do the church. We did the ceremony there. We didn't have to go anywhere. And it was a really nice place, but it's gone now, apparently.
Yeah, that just came up recently things gone and whatever on one of the social things. But my dad used to work at Vilda Park across the way.
Oh, yeah. Was that a
Now it's Mequon.
Is that a golf
club?
Golf course?
Cars. Yeah.
Blah, 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 blah. But, yeah. And then, my grandma, Aunt Teresa, she would always, like, occasionally... Be like, let's do a Easter, something, just get together quick. And it's like, oh, yeah, ooh.
Did you
even
call
as
her,
a little kid.
Did you call her Tess or Teresa?
No, grandma.
Grandma, yeah, right, grandma. Of course. Yeah.
Grandma.
She was Aunt Tess to me, but she would sneak me down and give me her homemade schnapps. Did she ever do that?
Oh, yeah.
Holy crap, it had crystals all over the mouth. She's like, try a little bit of this.
It's like...
And she's like this high.
Yeah, she was
with
Yoda.
A little head
She was
bob.
Full Yoda, yeah. She's
was, that, was that what the schnapps do to you after two?
I don't know. I was like, okay, I'm 13. I'm like, that was awesome.
Yeah, schnapps are like, you don't really know you're drinking the alcohol there.
But But who makes that? Like, do you know anybody that makes schnapps?
No, I wouldn't even know exactly how to make it.
She makes schnapps. Huh? Well, like, it's not like she had it. She made it.
Sweet.
And obviously. She had the cedar pickling rooms.
Or,
curing rooms and whatever. Like, for being a weird, normal-looking basement in Menominee Falls, it had a lot of weird shit in the basement.
Yeah.
Interesting. People don't sit in their houses much anymore.
Right?
Yeah, I don't know. My grandfather had the big bar. He was an elk. He had his buddies over. He had big, huge family things. And it was in a room not much bigger than this studio, I wouldn't think. And there would be like 30 people in there. in the basement of his house on Oakland Avenue with a fireplace down there and the flagstone and the bar. And yeah.
What's wrong with that? I love that.
Barb's kid and we ended up wrestling on what we thought was like padding, ended up being insulation.
Was it asbestos?
Oh, I don't know what it was.
but it hurt.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So we had to take turns getting like scrubbed down in Benadryl and taking baths. Or what was it? Whatever that pink shit was that like got all the crap out of you?
Yeah, Owens Corning.
I don't know.
Pink fiberglass.
Yeah. It's just explaining a lot of what's going on.
I got the scratch going here now.
Archie.
You guys been following the sit down restaurants like Red Lobster and Applebee's and all these places are losing. They're losing restaurants all over the place. I think Red Lobster even went bankrupt. They're on their way back out now, and their new president is like, "We're bringing back hush puppies."
And that's all it takes.
I didn't even know what a hush puppy was. It's like batter dropped into oil.
It's fried batter.
It's fried batter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh no, that's a thing.
Yeah. Apparently, that's a big thing in the Carolinas.
Jingle
and
King. Yeah. Jingle.
That's
King Keys.
Maybe that's why I know. I went to. Yeah. I lived in Chapel Hill. Well, Durham for a long time. So.
College town.
Chapel Hill is Durham. Is Duke is in Durham, but they don't like Durham. Has a wall around themselves.
It's a triangle. Of, right? It's just like a weird...
Durham is
It's a weird
another area.
Triangle of
However,
hatred.
However, Durham's kick-ass. In the last 20 years, it's exploded. It's great.
So did Asheville until it didn't.
Right.
Sad, sad days in Asheville. All right, everybody.
Did I tell you about Marshall, where our studio is? The river?
Oh, yeah. I think you told us, but you didn't tell us on the show, did you?
I guess I didn't.
Because you guys were in Asheville.
So the studio is on an island in the French Broad in Marshall, North Carolina. On Monday, the French Broad was a foot and a half deep. And on Thursday, it was 20 feet deep.
Jesus.
Wow.
Like, our studio is on the second floor. The entire first floor of the school was destroyed. And the water went right up to the floorboards of the studio. If you look at our studio, nothing happened. Wow. But the whole building is filled with silt. And
is
and
it
just,
still sound, the building?
Yeah, well, I don't know. I guess so.
It's brick? Or
I mean, they have floods. You know, you live on a river, you expect a flood.
Yeah, a couple, two, 3 feet here and there.
Right, but not 20. They lost whole cities. Whole cities got washed away. Yeah. It was crazy.
We've talked about our some people we know in Boone, which is 15 mm-hmm. miles away or something maybe. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it's upstream, probably.
But it's up a little bit.
Yeah. But they had, I don't know, 8 feet of water come through and destroy its powder coating. She's a bike builder.
Right.
A lot of stuff. They lost a lot of stuff. And even washed out the bridge that you had to go over to get to their house and stuff like that. And through the help of the bike community and many other people, I'm sure, they have gotten back on their feet more quickly than they planned. So that's a good thing.
That whole community... like bandied together like you wouldn't believe. Everybody was on top of it. They had a fashion show, and everybody was wearing their cleanup gear. Right? Like people are walking up in cleanup gear.
With the big old rubber boots on.
Yeah, right?
Yeah, right on. Cool. Well, good pull there, JK, with the DeNardo guest today.
Oh, I was walking out.
It's called producing. It's all timing. The universe provideth.
Just out of curiosity, is DeNardo a completely unique name, or are there other DeNardos in the world?
Not with my spelling, but there's another DeNardo who's almost exactly my age, and it's Ornette Coleman's son.
Wow, okay.
The drummer, DeNardo Coleman.
Does he have the apostrophe or no?
No, D-E.
Aha. Uh-huh. So you're the apostrophe.
I'm the apostrophe. I'm crux of the biscuit.
Right, right.
Or okay. percent dollar sign 39 or whatever that is in Mike's world. What the fuck? What happened there? Like, we had punch cards in the 30s, and that's it. You can't have any special symbols in, you can't have apostrophes, you can't have hyphens, you can't have quotes, because that's all special. And they use that for everything else. Never mind.
Typewriter got clever.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. Everything was better.
All right, D’Nardo, thanks for being on the show.
Thank you. I'm out of here.
We'll do this again next week. Maybe Tony will be back, I hope, hopefully. And
get well, Tony.
Good on
you. Get well, Tony.
Have some soup. Put a hot towel on your head.